NWBT, National Muslim Basketball Tour.
Of the Shuhada, of the Anbiya, on the Day of Judgment in Jannatul Firdaus, inshallah. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers, I'm not going to take too much time because I know you only have a few minutes and time is precious. I will just give you one instance from the Quran, from the life of Musa alayhi salam. Because when this happened, Musa alayhi salam was young, as all of us, right? Looking for the best life, looking for all of those things that any young man looks for, or young woman. I mean, there are sisters here, but I would have said, but this is what we look for, right? I mean, the best in the dunya. But if you know the Quran, you know the story of Musa. Musa alayhi salam, you remember that he accidentally kills one of the guys that belonged to Fir'aun. Right, he was with the Fir'aun, so he accidentally kills this worker, this guy, this soldier. So Fir'aun and his system of kufr, unjust system, what did it do? It kicked, they said, they punished Musa, they said, get out of our land. So Musa actually left. He was worried they were going to kill him, so he leaves and he goes to where? Madian. And here, this is the point that I want you to understand. Sometimes, brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He puts in our way an opportunity that when you take that opportunity, that one simple opportunity might open a million doors for you. That simple opportunity, you take it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of that one opportunity, because maybe you were courageous enough, you were brave enough, you were honest enough, you felt the pain of someone and you decided I can do something just because of that intention. Maybe you didn't even take the action because you couldn't complete it. That Allah Azza wa Jal, the creator of the universe, opens a million doors for you. And this is what happens to Musa alayhi salam. Think about it. He goes, and what happens? He is so tired. The Quran says that he's to a point, he is tired, he doesn't know where to go, he is thirsty, he is hungry, he's been walking for days, and he ends up in this place, this village, and what does he observe? And he just wants to sit down, to the point you will see the dua that he makes later. But he just wants to sit down, find a tree, some type of shade, just sit down, relax. He's been walking for so long. What happens? He sees few women who are trying to take water. And what happens? There are some jahil men, ignorant men, who don't know how to give the rights to women. They put the woman aside and they are fighting. They want to take the water. Nobody is asking, oh sister, do you need something? Oh my wife, do you need something? Oh my daughter, do you need something? I'm not saying it has to be Muslim. No. Because this ummah is of khair. It cares for anyone, even animals. Right? Because remember the hadith that a woman who was a prostitute, but because she cared for a dog who was thirsty, Allah said, your sins are forgiven and you're going to go to Jannah. But here is a woman, they're waiting. Musa alayhi salam observes this and he says, what's going on? He goes and he asks the woman, what do you need? We need water. Why don't you get it? No, these men, they're not going to let us be a woman. What can we do at this point? They're just... So Musa alayhi salam, this was his nature. Nature of Musa alayhi salam was when he sees something wrong, he has to correct it. يَعْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ تَنْحَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned this about the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةِ أُخْرَجِتْ لِلنَّاسِ يَعْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ تَنْحَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ And they believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. And then who? The creator of the universe. And they enjoin the good, they forbid the evil. When they see it, if not you being part of corruption, if you say nothing about corruption, dear brothers, you are aiding the corruption. If you see the corruption taking place, killing and all of this destruction taking place, and you say nothing, then you are part of that corruption. Because you're saying nothing. Then Musa alayhi salam, he goes, he moves the man, he gets the water, he gives it to the woman. And what does he do after he does what he does? He goes back to the tree and he makes that dua, the famous dua, oh Allah, anything that I can get now, anything, khairan faqih, Allah, anything, Ya Rab, that I can get, I'm in the need of, I need it now. Ya Allah, and he falls apart. And subhanAllah, within moments, what happens? The women go, they talk to their father, they come back, and they talk to Musa Aslam, they say, come, our father wants to meet you. Then what happens? Musa alayhi salam goes following them. You know the whole story, I'm sure. Even there is hikmah, even the way he followed. I don't want to go there. But he goes. The father gives him a job for 10 years, a contract. He says, because of what you did, he gives him a job for 10 years. Don't worry about anything. Offers his daughter in wedding, yani in marriage. He gets married. He has children. And more than that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of this, what happens? Allah gives him the nabuwah, gives him prophethood. Not just not a million-dollar job. That's nothing. Prophethood. Why? A simple glass of water. No, he didn't do anything. Did he fight for somebody? Did he go and did he wrestle somebody? None of that. All he does, he says, you need help. You can't do it yourself. Let me help you. And that one door, he takes the step, and Allah opens. Look to the point, all the way to Jannah. So dear brothers, here is an opportunity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us again. Brothers amongst you, there are brothers amongst you who are going to aid the brothers in Jordan. We all know what is taking place in Syria, in Sham in general, whether it's Palestine, whether it's Syria, whatever. There are brothers amongst you who have taken it upon themselves, and you know some of them. I don't want to mention, because I don't know all of their names. If I mention one, then I'm going to be like, I know they're not going to, but you know, they let their intention be pure, inshallah. And make sure that their intention is pure, especially those brothers who are going, and purify your intention for the sake of Allah. So the point here, brothers, they are going. They want to go and they want to help. Here is a way to help them and get the rewards. They might be struggling there, but you will be rewarded for it too. Here is an opportunity. I was told, don't ask for money. But brothers, there is no nation that has ever survived, that has ever become successful without the aid of its youth. The Prophet ﷺ, he used to say, take care of my youth. Take care of my youth, because they supported me when the elders, the heads of the tribe, all of them, they left me. But it was the tribe, the youth that supported the Prophet ﷺ became the army of Muhammad ﷺ, that today we can call ourselves Muslims. Today we can call ourselves Muslims because of that. So inshallah, let me do this. How many brothers we have here? A lot. That's a good answer, brother. A lot. I can count, let's say, at least 30 right here. 30 to 40 brothers. Maybe more. I don't know what's going on all the way over there. Do you think that each person here can do $100? 100. Just 100. That's maybe a month of coffee or whatever for some people, believe me. I mean, there are people, right? I mean, literally, Dunkin' Donuts is $1.99. I just had one. I know very well how much it costs. $1.99 is something like this. Or now, City of Chicago, $2.02. 20% tax, man, too much.
20%?
That's too much, man. But that's what's happening. So, if I can do $2 a day, I count it as $60. Okay. If we can just do 100, not for your own sake, that this 100 might put a bandage on a sister who was raped, on a brother who was cut in pieces. Who knows? Although, dear brothers, this is just temporary help. We know this is just temporary help. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He actually uses us to be part of these revolts to remove the most oppressive regimes on earth. That's what we usually ask. But because the brothers are going tonight, and give them any type of help that we can, if we can just raise hands for $100. One. Let's start here. One. Yeah. 100. MashaAllah. Khalas. One. We're going with them, it seems. Two. 100. Three. Four. Five. 100. Six. 7. 8. 9. 10. Yami. 11. 100. Can't do it, next dua. Can't do it, next dua. 12, 13. No, yes, Allah, may Allah give you, you can give, inshallah. Even if you can give a penny, I said, he just gave water. He just gave what? 13. He said, 14. Allah, okay, but I will give the rest, 14. 100, 15, 16, 17, 100, 18, 19, you are, did I count you already? Did I count? Oh, you're going. You're going to? 20. 100? No? 50? Voila. 21. 22. 23. 24. 25. Did I count you? 25, me 26. Voila. 26. Inshallah.